Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about independent events and probability trees, our first video on that topic. So let's start with something we've previously learned on Hegarty Maths. This question we did on the previous video, so pause the video and double check you can answer this. Well, the flipping of the coins twice are independent events. The first flip does not affect the second flip. So the probability of getting two heads, a head and a head, we can just say that's the probability of a head off the first coin multiplied by the probability of a head off the second coin, which would be equal to a quarter. Simple as that. Now, in this particular video, we're going to do questions of this nature. What is the probability in the same scenario of getting at least one head? Now, there are many ways of doing this, but often probability trees are a very nice, neat way of doing this, helping us get the right answer and understand what's going on. So let me just show you how a probability tree is drawn with this particular example in mind, and then you can go on and do others yourselves. Now, two things happen. You flip a coin the first time and you flip a coin the second time. So let's consider the first flip first. So on the first flip, there are two possible outcomes, right? You can either get yourself a head or you get yourself a tail, and we would label it like that. And the probability of a head we know is a half, and the probability of a tail we also know is a half. Now let's go along one particular line. Imagine we were to go along this line here. That is assuming on the first flip you got a head. Then you do your second flip. Now, two things can happen on the second flip, and they're the same as the two things that happened on the first flip. You can either get yourself a head or you get yourself a tail. And again, the probability of a head here, it's independent of the first head, it's still a half, and the probability of a tail here is a half. Okay? Now, if we were to instead of assume that we got a tail on the first flip and went down here, well, what we would do is we would, again, we've got an option of getting a head or a tail, and we would label this in like this, a head or a tail. And again, we know the probability of a head is a half, and the probability of a tail is a half. So let's list all the possible outcomes. Here and here would be a head, then a head. Here and then here would have been a head, then a tail. Here, then here would have been a tail, then a head. And finally, along here and along here is a tail, then a tail. Now suppose we wanted to work out the probability of each of these. So I'm going to put a probability of this around it, just so we know what we're talking about here. How do we do that? Well, we multiply along the probability lines. Just up here, as we did a probability of a head times a probability of a head, that's what we do along the tree here. So a half times a half is clearly a quarter. Along here would be a half times this half, which would be a quarter again. Here would be half times a half, again is a quarter. And the last one would also be a quarter. So we can state all our outcomes and the probability of each. Now, that wasn't the question. We were asked what the probability was of getting at least one head. So let's look back at our scenarios here. This gets us at least one head, it gets us two. This one does, and this one does. So we add up these. A quarter add a quarter add a quarter is equal to 3/4, and we've done that question then. Okay, let's go on and try some more questions about successive events and using probability trees to solve them. Pause the video and have a go at this question if you can. Okay, there is a bag filled with 3 blue and 5 red marbles. Paul picks one out of the bag, notes its colour, and this is really important, and he replaces it after. So he puts the ball back in, he then takes a marble back in, he then takes another marble, draw a probability tree to represent this. So let's have a go. So in the first scenario, let's think what happens. So he can either get a blue or a red marble. Okay, so he can either get a blue or a red. Blue. Now, what's the probability of getting a blue marble? Let's think about it. There are 3 of them out of a total of 8 marbles, so it's 3/8. And the probability of getting a red here, well, there's 5 out of a total of 8. And remember, these must always add to 1, and 5/8 and 3/8 do indeed add to 1. Now, on the second scenario, let's think what happens here. He can again either get a blue or a red, so it's exactly the same as before, a blue or red, a blue or red. And I'm just going to populate those myself, so without much talking, so you can just watch me do that. So let's work out the probability of getting each possible outcome. Along here we can work out the probability of a blue then a blue, which is going to be 3/8 multiplied by 3/8, which is going to be 9/64. This one here is the probability of a blue then a red, which is going to be 3/8 multiplied by 5/8, which is going to be 15/64. Here we're going to get the probability of a red then a blue, which is going to be 5/8 multiplied by 3/8, which again is 15/64. And down here is the probability of a red times the probability of a red, which is going to be 5/8 multiplied by 5/8, which is 25/64. And we have drawn a fully labeled probability tree. Now that's not the end of the story. They actually go on and ask you some questions, but if you've labeled this up properly, you should be able to answer anything they give you. So let's have a go. So the same question, they subsequently ask, what's the probability of getting two reds? The probability of a red and a red, like that. We've actually already done that. It is here, 25/64, done. Next, they ask the probability of getting two blues, so a blue and then a blue. So go back here, and actually, again, you will see we've done that. The answer is 9/64. Then it says the probability of two same colours. Well, to get the same colours, you either got, if you look at here, you will either have to get blue and blue or red and red. They're your only options. So you just have to add these two. 9/64, add 25/64. Which is going to be equal to 34/64. You can simplify this, divide top and bottom by 2, and you would get 17/32 as well. Okay, then it says, what's the probability of getting two different colours? So the probability of getting two different, well, it is this one here and this one here combined. 15/64, add another 15/64, it is going to be 30/64, which again, you can simplify, and you would get yourself 15/32. What's the probability of getting exactly one blue? Let's look back here. Well, here you got two blues, that's no good. Here you got one blue, here you got one blue, and here you didn't. So it's these two added up again, which is exactly as before, 30/64, which simplifies to 15/32. What's the probability of at least one blue? Okay, the probability of at least one blue is going to be this. I get two blues here, so that's at least one blue. It's that one, add that one, because in all of these scenarios we get at least one blue. So it's 15/64, add 15/64, which is 30/64, add 9/64, which is 39/64. Just one thing I'd like to point out, whenever you get these questions of at least one of something, in this case at least one blue, if you look back here, at least one blue, it's all the scenarios except for the one where there is no blue, right? So potentially an easier way of doing it would just be to do 1 subtract this answer here where there's no blue, because 1 subtract that gives you all the cases where you would have one blue or more. So you could have just done here 1 subtract and no blue was 25/64, and you would have got the answer 39/64. Okay, next one. Pause the video and have a go. Okay, in this scenario here, Caroline buys fruit and then she independently buys a CD. Work out the probability she buys fruit or buys a CD or buys both. Now, let's assume that Caroline buys the fruit first, and let's assume subsequent to that she buys the CD or doesn't buy the CD. So let's draw a probability tree. The first thing is buying fruit or not. The second thing is buying a CD or not. So I'm just going to draw that for you now. I'm going to label the probabilities in here. I'm not going to write P fruit anymore. I'm just going to say that 0.7. And not fruit must be 1 subtract this, obviously, which would be 0.3. Similarly, CD here, the probability of that is 0.2. Not CD would be 1 subtract that, would be 0.8. Now I'm going to fill in all the possible outcomes over here and the probabilities. Now, as before, you multiply along the probability tree, and we're multiplying decimals here. 0.7 multiplied by 0.2 is 0.14. 0.7 multiplied by 0.8 is 0.56. 0.3 multiplied by 0.2 is 0.06, and 0.3 multiplied by 0.8 is 0.24. Now the question was, what's the probability she buys fruit, or buys a CD, or buys both? Well, here she buys fruit, here she and a CD, here she buys fruit, here she buys a CD, and here she doesn't have either fruit or CD. So it's the sum of these, that and that and that, which if you add up is 0.76. Alternatively, you could have done 1 subtract the case where she doesn't buy fruit or a CD, which would give you all of these added up, which may have been easier if you had done 1 subtract 0.24. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks loads for watching.